So that leaves only one question. How do you play the game? The first thing to do is assign the order of play. You can obviously choose any arbitrary method to figure this out, but keep in mind that the first to tee off will be assigned the button. Just like in poker, the button indicates who has the honor, and it will be passed down through the order of play as your group moves from hole to hole. Keep in mind that regardless of who is furthest from the pin, the player on the button will always hit first, and the rotation stays the same from tee to green. The gambling action begins with antes, which are 1% of your purse and double every three holes.
10,000.
The first round of betting begins before each player takes his second shot, and the golfer with the button acts first. Just like in poker, you can fold, check, or raise. But to avoid any confusion, there is only one round of betting per shot, and there is no check raising. Unlike at the poker table, in the World Series of Golf, everyone can see the cards you've been dealt.
You do see what the other player is holding. In other words, you get to see where he lies and where you lie. So the real question about how to gamble on this is really, what do you want your opponent to do, and how do you get him to do it?
Unless you really know the golfer you're up against, you don't know his strengths and his weaknesses. So for me, I'm going to use the first few holes like I would at a poker table to kind of feel them out and get a feel for, like, where's this guy bad? And if he's bad on the putting green, that's where I'm going to stick the big bets in.
Rounds of betting continue in between each shot, but to see action on the green, you've got to make it there. And in this format, that isn't guaranteed. Play ends when the hole is won traditionally by a player, or earlier if everyone is folded to a bettor.
This is like a poker game, and they deal the cards every 2 minutes. Do not stay in unless you've got a really good hand.
But you may not putt or chip until late in the round, and next thing you know, you have to do that for sometimes all in. It puts a lot of pressure on your game when you have to putt and chip, and you haven't actually, you had no feel at that point. You haven't done it since the driving range, basically.
You don't have to win every hole, you know, and you're playing a golf tournament back home. If you have a bad hole, you know, you got to fight like crazy to come back, and you're probably out of it. You know, if you make a 7 or 8, a triple bogey, you're done. Well, here, guess what? You just say, I fold. We'll go to the next hole, and the antes go up. You may lose the ante for that hole, but you're not completely out of it.
To help you better understand this unique format of play, let's take a look at a hole from the 2007 World Series of Golf. Since this is the first hole of the championship match, the group has 5 players and antes are already at 1,200 a man. $6,000 is at stake before anyone has struck a ball. Notice that the players hit their drives from different tees. This is to even the playing field. The higher your golfing handicap, the closer you'll start to the pin.
Advisor, advise him to be non-nerves. Pretty good advice, I tell you.
Mark Ewing's got nothing to be nervous about. After a great drive, his ball lies in the middle of the fairway, and he's got the button.
Mark, you check?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ken Tanner has a terrible lie, but with no one betting yet, he checks behind Mark.
Tanner checks as well.
Poker pro Phil Ivey might be confident on the felt, but his position on this hole isn't good enough for him to offer up a bet.
Phil Ivey checks. The bets to Mr. Butler.
Rhett Butler, on the other hand, realizes he's the player closest to the pin and raises the stakes.
Megan, 6,000, 4,800 plus.
Rhett Butler bets 4,800.
And then Rhett bet 4,800.
Paul Schuler shanked his drive and quickly folds.
1,200 ante and then 4,800.
I will fold.
Okay.
Action now returns to Ewing, having checked. He can call the bet, but cannot raise. With more money at stake, Tanner's distance from the hole now looks a little too daunting, and he picks up.
Mr. Tanner folds.
Ivy is the third player who found the fairway on his drive and calls the bet as well. Tanner and Schuler will regroup and prepare for the second hole, while the threesome of Ewing, Butler, and Ivy will take their second shots with 20,400 now in the pot. Just like on the poker table, the action is now three-handed, with Ewing hitting first, and his great approach will put a lot of pressure on the other two players still in the hole. Ivy's second shot sails long, and Butler will end up looking at a long putt. With a great shot at birdie, Ewing clearly has the advantage here and will look to capitalize on that with his bet.
What about 30,000?
Ivy's off the green and takes himself out of the hole by folding. Butler's putt looks a little too far for him, and he also folds, conceding the hole and the pot to Mark Ewing. At this point, the hole is over. Notice that no one actually finished the hole, but of course Mark Ewing won't be complaining, having added $20,400 to his chip count, not only by hitting great golf shots, but also by aggressively betting the other players out of the hole.